Every morning at the mine, you can see him arrive. He stood 6'6" and weighed 245, kind of broad at the shoulder and narrow at the hip. And everybody knew he didn't give no lip to Big John. Big Bad John. Nobody seemed to know where John called home. He just drifted into town and stayed all alone. He didn't sing much, he kind of quiet and shy. And if he spoke at all, he just said hi to Big John. Somebody said he came from New Orleans, where he got in a fight over a Cajun queen and a crashing blow from a huge right hand sent a Louisiana fella to the promised land, Big John. Big Bad John. Then came the day at the bottom of the mine when a timber cracked and men started crying. Miners were praying and hearts beat fast, and everybody thought that they'd breathed their last, said John. Through the dust and the smoke of this man-made hell walked a giant of a man that the miners knew well, grabbed the sag and the timber and gave out with a groan, and like a giant old tree just stood there alone, Big John. Big Bad John. And with all of his strength, he gave a mighty shove. Then a miner yelled out, "There's a light up above." And 20 men scrambled from a would-be grave. And now there's only one left down there to save Big John. With Jackson timbers, they started back down. Then came that rumble way down in the ground. And smoke and gas melched out of that mine.